Hello ladies and gentlemen, how do you do? Welcome to this edition of Programming Wizards. Now guys, for today I want to introduce you to the drop down list. Okay, drop down list in ASP.NET. Actually we shall be using C# in this tutorial, but in the very next tutorial we shall be talking about it in ASP.NET, VB.NET. okay, now this is what we're going to see. We're going to see how to add, update, delete and clear items to and from a drop down list. This is our drop down list. You can see it is empty. Now if I come right here, I start typing my stuff. You can see if I click add, the page refreshes and it gets added. If I come, for instance, add this one, okay, we are adding our items right there. You can also come right here and just add like almost all of them right there. Okay, what about if you want to update? For instance, if you want to update, I can just I can just come right here. Once I selected Game of Thrones, then let's say that I want to update it with something like, let me just call it something like game. Okay, then if I come right here, I click update, you can see it has updated it. If I select the crisis and let's say that I want to update it with something like this one, then I come right here, I click update, you can see it updates it right there. What about if I select this one and I want to update it with let me call it this way, then it gets updated. What about deleting? Let's say that I select this one and then I want to delete, I can just click delete and it gets deleted. If I want to delete this one, just come delete. If I want to delete everything, I just click clear and it clears everything from our drop down list. This is what we're going to see. It's a simple tutorial. Welcome, we get started. The first thing I'll need you to create a project, ASP.NET, a web form site. Okay, we're using web forms, so just come right here. I select the language. For me, I'm using Visual C#. Then you can see right here, it's web form. That you type the name of your project, then click OK. Okay, now does it, it shall generate for you the project. Then for me, you can see it has generated for me this template, but I've just added my components to save us some time. Actually this is no big deal. You just delete whatever is there, then you come to toolbox, then just drag your components right there. Okay, if you want whatever you want your component to appear, you just go. For instance, let's say that I want my component to appear right here. I just come right here, and for instance, if it is a button, I just double click a button, and you can see there's really no big deal about it. Just design your form the way you like. Now you can see, for instance, my text box, I've just given it in the properties show txt right there. My buttons, I've given it like this is the add button, this is update button, delete button and clear button. Then for your drop down list, I just come right here, click where you want your drop down list to appear, then come and double click drop down list right here. You can see it's empty, there's really nothing about it. This is a label. So that's it. Once you've done so, I know first click your add button, it shall generate for us that event that you're going to handle, then update button, then delete button, then clear button. Okay, now we shall start with the clearing, which is simple. It's just a one line stuff. To clear, just come and say drop down list one, which is our drop down, then dot items. This one shall give us a collection of all the items. Then we call its clear method, and that's it. They shall clear for us our drop down list. Okay, what about if you want to add? No, adding is also simple. What we simply do, just come and say drop down list one dot items, give us a collection of items. Then we call it add method. Then we type what we want to add. Of course, what we want to add is what the user shall type in the show txt. So show txt dot text, they shall add for us our item right there. Now once we've added it, what we shall want to do, we shall want to clear our text box, just to give the user a visual feedback that we've added an item. Okay, so with that one, we just come and say show txt dot text, we just set it to empty. is that simple. In fact, this one I'll copy it because we shall be reusing it. Now, what about updating? To update, there are several steps that we're going to need. First, we shall need to get position, okay? Get the item that we want to update, we'll get its position. Now, to do that one, just come and say selected pos, which is selected position, equal to drop down list one, okay? Then actually what we're going to do, we're just going to call the selected index. Now selected index shall give us the index of the selected item. It's an integer. After getting the position, the next thing that we're going to do, we're going to remove the item at that particular index, okay? So we call remove. Now to remove is simple, int, no, sorry, we just call drop down list one, okay? Then dot items, then dot remove at. Now dot remove at, what we're going to do, we're just going to pass the index of the item that we want to remove, of course, selected pos, that is our index. Then we clear, and that's it, okay? That's how we are going to be updating our stuff. Oh, of course, no, that is removing. Once we've removed, of course, we need to add, sorry, we need to add now the item at that particular position. And to do that one is simple. We just come and write here and say drop down list dot items. Now what we're going to do, we're going to call insert, okay? We call insert. Then for insert shall requires to pass the index for where we want to insert it, which is our selected position and the item that we want to insert. Of course, we shall want to insert the item that the user shall be have typed. So that's it. That's how we're going to remove, okay? That's how we're going to update, I mean. Now what about to delete? To delete is very simple. We're just going to copy paste this one for removing. Now we just copy paste this one and bring it here. First we just get the position of the item that we want to delete, and then we remove the item at that particular position. Then of course, just to give a visual feedback to the user, we're just going to clear, and that's it, guys. In fact, we are through. Let's just run our project and have a look. And here is our simple project. What about if you want to add? Now to add, for instance, I come right there, type, I click add, it adds it, it refreshes, and now we can see. If I want to add more, I can just add more, okay? And then I come add this one, then maybe go them as the last one. So once we've added those ones, what about if you want to update? For instance, we can come right here and you want to update it as thrones, okay? Now I just come click here, update, and then it updates. You can see right here, okay? What about if just this one, I just want to update it that way? You can see it updates it. What about if I want to delete an item? For instance, if that one, I come click here, delete, you can see it deletes it. Then I can also clear my drop down list right here. Guys, that's it. We've seen how to do it in C sharp. In the next tutorial, we shall see how to do it in VB.net. Please, guys, if you love the tutorial, you can leave a comment down below. You can like this video. You can share it with friends and family. Okay? And please subscribe so that you continue receiving tutorials like this ones on a regular basis. Take care. I'll catch you in the next tutorial.